Hello, everybody. I guess most of you have seen our science fiction movies like Star Wars or Star Trek. But this is not a science fiction movie. This is not computer graphics. This is a real video I and my crewmates took on board Space Shuttle Discovery in 2010. After it separated from the International Space Station, ISS. The ISS is continuous rotating around the Earth at the speed of Mach 25. This is a real speed, which is 8 kilometers per second. No fast forwarding. So sharing with this video with you, I'd like to share three things with you today. First, the beauty of the Earth. As you see in this video, we can see great nature like mountains, rivers, white clouds, and blue oceans. And sometimes at the northern poles and southern poles, we can even see northern lights, auroras. It's just breathtaking. But at the same time, it is surprising to see the layer of the atmosphere. It's so thin, and it's so surprising to know we are all protected by this thin and fragile layer of the atmosphere. And during sunset and sunrise, which occurs every 90 minutes, the layer of the atmosphere shine in rainbow colors, which is beautiful. And Buck Mr. Fuller described the Earth as Starship Earth. And I felt myself, the Earth is a starship. It's one globe. But it is, of course, it is huge, but it is not infinite. The land and the resources are all limited, right? So we have to operate the spaceship Earth in a better way because still the global population and energy consumption are growing and growing. So we have to operate the spaceship Earth in a better way, putting our resources not in conflicts, but in positive ways. And second, I'd like to share the power of human beings. Well, during daytime, we see great nature, but at night, we can see city lights a lot, and it's very shiny. And it kind of seemed like a symbol of human civilization. And also, I was very surprised to see the ISS when I approached to it and separated from it, like in this video. It's so huge. It's 100 meters wide and 75 meters long. And it's just like a soccer field size. So huge. And it's an international collaboration. So it seemed like a human, borderless collaboration. And the ISS project started in 1980s among Western countries, United States, European countries, Canada, and Japan. But after the Cold War was over, early 90s, then Russia joined in this project. So things can move forward. And more nations are expected to collaborate if in a future space human exploration to the moon or to Mars or beyond. Because if you want to go to Mars, it will go beyond one nation's project. So we need more collaboration among nations. And in order to do that, probably we need more stable politics or economics on the ground as well. So we need more borderless world. And on the other hand, I guess, putting our forces in this challenging space exploration probably will help to make the world borderless more, because we need to collaborate more. So I would like to expect and see this kind of good synergetic collaboration, synergetic effect on the ground and the space. Well, recently I was so impressed to see the picture of Pluto taken by New Horizons. Congratulations to the New Horizons team for their achievement. And I'd like to respect and thank all the people all over the world who have dedicated their lives in space missions and support space missions. Well, third and lastly, I'd like to share Mother Space. Well, when I first reached space and felt microgravity just 8 minutes and 30 seconds after its launch, very quick, right? I was so impressed. Well, in microgravity, you can make somersaults many, many times. You can hang from the ceiling, or you can even stand on the ceiling with no problems. There is no absolute up and down. It's up to your posture. So I had to say, hey, look, you're up, or look, you're down in space, instead of just up and down, because it's different each person. So it's an eye-opening environment. I had to put myself in the other person's shoe. Otherwise, we wouldn't be able to understand each other. And I was also very impressed because I felt somehow familiar when I first reached the space, although it was my first time. Well, we are all made of star stuff. The sun, the earth, every creature, including us, are made of star stuff. So space is not a place far away. Probably it is our hometown. So that seems why I felt familiar in space. I'd like to call it Mother Space. And Mother Space should play for us, for our happiness and peace, just like parents wish their children their happiness, or teachers wish their students' happiness. And Mother Space should want us to see, you know, want to see us growing up and getting more matured. And Mother Space should want to see us caring each other and collaborating more on the ground as well. Well, the view of the Earth from space is beautiful, but when I landed to the ground and I felt the breeze and I saw the, you know, the scenery and I smelled a small flower and green and trees, I felt so precious and happy. So I guess probably all the happiness is in our surroundings, not far away. All the happiness is in our surroundings. So to have such an idea probably will connect the world more borderless and even connect the ground and space. And I believe Mother Space is waiting for us. By collaborating more, then we will enable to fly to space or even live in space eventually. So I'd like to do my best to make space close and accessible to more and more people. And I believe that will collaborate and contribute to the borderless world. So I think Mother Space is waiting for us. Thank you for your listening, and thank you for all the contribution to this TED and to this daily project. I appreciate it. Thank you so much.